of AAJC was to create a Pan-Asian front. How were you successful with that? How were you able to do it, especially with the disparate and diverse and very wide range of people and cultures that you're trying to fuse together?
Well, one of the things we learned in bringing the Asian American community together is you really have to start with where people come in. So they come in with whatever their ethnicity is first, or their religion. And we help them organize first on that level. And then we get them together with other communities, and they see that, in fact, they have shared challenges. And they begin to see the power of working together. The community partners network is one of the things that helped us to do that. We started to identify on the local level where are these emerging leaders in their communities. And then we brought them together at a conference, and I believe McKinney Associates was there helping to do media training as well. And it was so exciting because people were able to see that they had generational issues. You know, that the younger people were saying, hey, the older leaders won't let us help lead. And it's not just my community, it's a generational question. And there are people who have tried different things that we can try. We don't need to reinvent the wheel. And so that's been very satisfying work. And then once we've put together a more Pan-Asian sense, then we've brought them in together with Latinos and African Americans and other communities where they can see the issues that they share and the dreams they share and the goals that every community, every family wants to meet, and to see how when they work together they can become an overwhelming force.